standing on top of the Mullins Glacier, which may be the oldest glacier in the world, and really that's why we've come to drill in Mullins and Beacon Valley. The Mullins Glacier originates from snowfall in the headwall just to the right. Snow accumulates very, very slowly, a centimeter or so a year. This glacier flows very, very slowly from the headwall out to this point, and then about 4 kilometers beyond Down Valley to the north. We measured, or others have measured, the horizontal velocity of this glacier, and it's moving about 40 millimeters per year at the headwall, but only a couple of millimeters per year here, and even stagnant in its distant regions. If you integrate modern horizontal flow velocities over time, then it's possible that the ice in the center of the valley near the terminus of this glacier is as much as 10 million years old. We want to know if that's possible because the bubbles within this glacier would preserve an archive of atmospheric evolution, perhaps over the last 10 million years. And that's fundamentally why we've come to drill here. Okay, assuming we can drill down to great depths in this glacier, why do we care? What's in this glacier that's of significance? Well, it's the gases that are trapped in tiny bubbles. As any glacier forms, snowfall is compacted to fern and then to glacier ice. And as the glacier ice forms, those bubbles are preserved and they can't escape. So they hold intact a sample of the Earth's atmosphere at the time the snow fell. And if this glacier goes from modern all the way to 8 to 10 million years, there's a potential record of atmospheric evolution over that duration. Where we're standing now, our modeling and our dating suggests the ice is about 1.5 million years in age, meaning we have atmosphere that old, making it by far the oldest atmosphere yet uncovered. Question is that atmosphere pristine, or have these vertical sand wedges allowed modern air to move down the glacier and old air to move up, creating a mixture of gases? That's part of the problem in drilling these debris-covered glaciers. We've got to get below the surface of thermal contraction, below the depth that these polygons interfere with pristine glacier ice. At this spot, we drilled to 28 meters, and we think with that depth, we've accessed pristine air. We won't know until we get back to the lab and analyze it. One of the bigger problems we're working on, in addition to understanding atmospheric evolution, is the long-term climate history of the planet, say the last 50 million years or so. And a lot of people are working on this problem, and there is some consensus on the early part of the Cenozoic. But as you get towards the present, there's been some debate. The problem is as follows. For the last 50 million years, global climate has essentially been cooling. Superimposed on that gradual cooling trend are three jumps where the climate cooled abruptly into a new state. The first cooling step occurred at about 34 million years ago, and it registers the onset of continental-sized glaciation on Antarctica. The second step, we think at about 14 million years ago, registers the imposition of polar desert climates in Antarctica, turning it into the deep freeze of today. The third step, at about 2.5 to 3 million years ago, registers the onset of northern hemisphere glaciation. The real unknown in this series of three cooling steps is the middle one. It's unknown whether or not the step around 14 million years ago occurred right then, or perhaps delayed until 3 or 4 million years ago, as some suggest. So there's about 10 million years in the view of some as to when Antarctica got into its present state. One of the benefits of studying this particular glacier is it can help address that question. If the climate on Antarctica cooled to its deep freeze state as recently as 3 to 4 million years ago, then we wouldn't preserve ancient ice that's 10 million years in age. And we think this particular glacier originates at the headwall, passes this point, which is about 1.5 million years in age, and continues down the valley to where it may be as much as 10 million years in age. If that's true, then that indicates that the deep freeze conditions that we now see started or began by at least 10 million years ago.